So when we've got real values, and this is sort of a primer for a later for the boot camp, for a reminder for those of you who've been out of math classes for a while. When we've got continuous data, we will often use Euclidean distance as the distance as a way of measuring similarity. Actually, really, as a way of measuring dissimilarity, because it's higher if the the more unlike the objects are. So this formula might be a little intimidating to some people, but I promise you that you are familiar with Euclidean distance. You just maybe don't know the term. Euclidean distance is what you'd hear call a distance formula, just the distance formula in your sort of high school algebra classes. And most people have seen it in two dimensions and sometimes three. But one of the very nice things about the Euclidean distance is that it generalizes very naturally to as many dimensions as you want. So in order to calculate the Euclidean distance between two data objects, we take the difference in each attribute value, square it, and then sum that and take the square root. So for instance, we have 4 points here with at 0, 2, 2, 0, 3, 1, and 5, 1 that are all at different plotted at different points. And we can construct a distance matrix describing how dissimilar all of our points are. So point 1 and point 4 are the most dissimilar. They're the farthest apart. Whereas point 2 and point 3 are the most similar. They're the closest together. Point 3 is also fairly similar to point 4, whereas point 2 is somewhat less similar from point 4. So another distance metric that we see particularly in the context of documents is called cosine similarity. So we have documents. We have turned them into term vectors. We can find how similar cosine similarity is a measure of similarity, not of dissimilarity. We can find how similar the two documents are by thinking of each of them as vectors, taking their dot product, which for those of you who never had it or don't remember your college vector calculus classes, you take each attribute by attribute, and you multiply them together across your two different objects. So 3 times 1, 2 times 0, 0 times 0. Maybe this is play, and this is coach, and this is tournament. And so we'll do our counts, and then we'll multiply them all together, document to document, and sum that all up. And then we end up dividing by the magnitude, by the product of the magnitudes. So the product of the magnitudes is just you square each attribute, add them all up, and take the square root. So in this case, we have a dot product of 5. We have a D1 and a D2 of 6.481 and 2.245. Those are our magnitudes. So we multiply these two together and divide 5 by that, and we end up with a cosine similarity of 0.315. Cosine similarity is a really nice metric for documents because it gives us this very clean 0-to-1 measurement that really does that suffers less from the curse of dimensionality than something like Euclidean distance does. So because document vectors tend to get very, very long, because there's a lot of different words in a given language, and given, and documents might have lots of different words in them, cosine similarity is a way to avoid some of the curse of dimensionality. And we'll talk about this more when we talk about encoding documents more directly in the bootcamp.